This is the first state of matter which we are going to discuss in class 11, that is the gases. Otherwise, pichli wali class mein humne kya kiya tha? We have the solids, the liquids and the gases. Solids, they are rigid. Liquids, they are fluids. And gases, they are going to be compressible. ठीक है, characteristic properties of gases भी हमने last वाले chapter में कर ली थी, जिसमें हमने बोला the molecules they are far away and the intermolecular spaces they are very large, whereas intermolecular forces of attraction in this case they are going to be negligible. ठीक है, and depending upon that we also said that when we are applying pressure, the molecules of the gas they come together, which is known as compression of gas. Now to explain the various characteristics of gases, there were many scientists who tried to give relationship between the state variables of gases, that is pressure, volume and temperature. Okay? So depending upon that, we are going to discuss this gas laws. It is said that the gases, they should supposedly be following these laws, jo bhi isme mathematical expression de rakha hota hai, that should be followed by all gases. Okay? So let's go on to the laws one by one. The first law which we are going to do, that is the Boyle's law, right? Now according to the Boyle's law, he stated that the pressure of the gas, if we are keeping the temperature of any system constant, if temperature is kept constant, the pressure of the gas, that is inversely proportional to volume, right? Or in other words, we can say that PV, that is going to be equal to constant. Okay? Now basically it is relating what? It is relating pressure and volume at constant temperature. Okay, so PV, that is going to be a constant. Or we can say that for mathematical calculations, P1 V1, that is equal to P2 V2. ठीक है, so जो भी numericals आएंगे वो हमने इससे करने. Now if we are saying that Boyle's law has to be verified, it can be verified experimentally by the following graphs. The first graph which we have, that is a graph between pressure and volume. Pressure and volume. So if we are taking pressure over here and we are taking volume over here, we are taking the mass of the gas constant and also we are taking temperature. That is going to be constant, right? So the graph that is going to come like this, that with increase in pressure, the volume of the gas that, or decrease in pressure, the volume of the gas that keeps on increasing. Okay? The second graph which we can relate is, that is between pressure and reciprocal of volume. So if we are taking the graph between pressure and 1 by V, then the graph that is coming as a straight line. Now if we are plotting various graphs at different temperatures, that is this is T1, this is T2, this is T3, right? So these are known as isotherms. These are known as isotherms. Okay. Now over here, T3 that is going to be greater than T2 is greater than T1. Okay. So isotherms, they are the relationship or graphs between pressure and reciprocal of volume at constant temperature. ठीक है? फिर उसके बाद, if we are plotting a graph between PV and P, take P over here and take PV over here, right? If you are plotting a graph between PV and P, then the graph that is going to be parallel to the P axis. So if you take in pressure over here and you take in PV over here, the graph would be shown like this. It is parallel to the axis to which you have taken pressure. Or if we are plotting it in the other manner, that is, we are taking PV over here and we are taking P over here. Then in that case, this is how the graph will be shown. So this is at T1, this is at T2 and this is at T3. Similarly, that T1 is less than T2 is less than T3. Okay? So these are the graphical representations. You also sometimes get a graph, and if you're lucky enough, ki simple sa question aa gaya ki graph is given and they say ki which of the following laws they are in relationship with which of the following graphs. Okay? So this is the Boyle's law. The second law which we are going to do, that is the Charles law. Second law we have is the Charles law. So Charles law hota hai, that gives us a relationship between volume and temperature. Right? Volume and temperature. In this case, pressure that is going to be constant. Okay? Pressure is constant. Now over here, the law states that volume is inversely proportional to pressure. Or in other words, in other words, we are saying volume and temperature hai. So here, if pressure that is kept constant, it is said that volume is directly proportional to temperature. So as we increase the temperature, what is going to happen? The volume of the gas that is going to increase. Okay, that is the Charles law. Now, when we are talking of the Charles law, it can also have another expression in which it is said that for every 1 degree rise in temperature, the volume of the gas that is going to increase by a certain amount. Okay? So, according to this expression, we say that if V naught is the volume at 0 degree Celsius and Vt is the volume at 3 degree Celsius, then the value of Vt that is going to be equal to V naught, which is the initial volume, plus V naught upon 273 into temperature. Okay? Or we can also say, taking V naught constant over here or V naught as common, we will get V naught outside and we will have 1 plus upon 273. Okay, so this is the expression for Charles law. Yeah, if we further solve karna chaho, so we will have Vt that is equal to 273 plus T upon 273 into V naught. Into V naught. Okay? So this is going to be the expression for Charles law. Let's come back to this expression which we've done over here. V is directly proportional to T. Okay? Yeah, you can write V upon T. That is going to be a constant. And for your numericals, V1 upon T1, that is going to be equal to V2 upon T2. Now when we are drawing a graph over here, the graph between volume and temperature. So let's say this is 0 Kelvin, right? This is 0 Kelvin, and after 0 Kelvin we can say that when the temperature is increased, the volume of the gas will keep on increasing. Now, if you extrapolate this, this will reach a value which has zero volume, right? Now, this temperature at which, you have to have this for 273 degrees Celsius. 273 degrees Celsius. Okay, so this temperature at which volume of the gas becomes zero, that temperature is known as absolute zero. And absolute zero is the temperature which is 0 Kelvin or minus 273 degree Celsius. Now basically at 0 Kelvin the gases do not exist. So it means that at 0 Kelvin the gases, they get converted into either liquids or solids, right? So we are saying that at 0 Kelvin the gases either convert to liquids or they convert to gases, right? Now you know what the Kelvin scale is and its conversion. Kelvin, that is going to be equal to 273 plus degree Celsius, right? Now if we are drawing these graphs at different pressures, then these graphs, they are said to be isobars, right? Over here, if you are taking this is as P1, this is as P2, and this is as P3. So over here, P3 is going to be greater than P2, is going to be greater than P1. Okay, so this is the second law, which is the Charles law. The third law which we are going to do, that is the Gay-Lussac's law. Third law, that is known as the Gay-Lussac's law. It is also known as pressure-temperature law. Gay-Lussac's law, which is also known as pressure-temperature law, right? Now, according to this law, if the volume of a gas that is kept constant, then pressure of a gas is directly proportional to temperature. Okay? Pressure of the gas, that is going to be directly proportional to temperature, or we say that P upon T, that is going to be constant, or mathematically for your numericals, P1 upon T1, that is equal to P2 upon T2. And if we are drawing a graph between pressure and temperature at various volumes, the graph comes to like this, where this is V1, this is V2, this is V3. Then in this case, V3 is greater than V2, is greater than V1. These graphs, they are known as isobars. Okay? Now let's combine the Boyle's law and the Charles law to get the ideal gas equation. What does ideal gas equation say? It says that according to Boyle's law, what did we say? Pressure is inversely proportional to volume, according to Boyle's law. Or we can write that volume is inversely proportional to pressure. Okay? According to Charles' law, volume is directly proportional to temperature. If we are combining both, so combining both, what will we get? Combining both, we will get volume is
directly proportional to T upon V, right? Or PV, that is going to be directly proportional to temperature, right? Or we say PV, that is equal to RT for 1 mole, where R, that is known as the gas constant, right? And if you're talking for N moles, this value will become PV is equal to NRT. This is going to be for N moles, right? Now let's understand how do we manipulate the value of R. So over here, we have the expression PV, that is equal to RT for 1 mole, okay? Or we say that the value of R, that is equal to PV for N moles, it is going to be NRT. PV upon NT, that is going to be value of R, okay? Now over here, the temperature has the unit Kelvin, which does not change, and number of moles also will not change. The units of P and V may change, which have different values. Okay, depending upon the units of pressure and volume, we give the values of R. So let's say that if we are taking the value of pressure or the unit of pressure as atmosphere and the unit of volume in liters, we know that every gas at STP, that is going to occupy 22.4 liters. Okay, so you have 22.4 liters surface area. The value of R in this case, that is going to be equal to 0.082 atmosphere liter per mole per Kelvin, right? In the second, we are not changing the value of pressure. We are only going to change the value of volume in milliliters. So in milliliters means you have to multiply this by 1000. So let's say if it has 1 over here, the value of this will become 82.1 atmosphere milliliter per mole per Kelvin. Okay? Now let's change the value over here into, we are taking now the value of pressure in dynes per centimeter square. So we're taking it in dyne per centimeter square, right? And we are taking the value of volume in 22400 milliliters. Then the value of R will be taken as 8.314 into 10 raised to power 7 dyne per centimeter square milliliter per mole per Kelvin. Okay? Now we know that this is in ergs also, dyne per centimeter square and milliliter, that is going to be in ergs, and 1 joule, that is equal to 10 raised to power 7 ergs. So this value can also be written as 8.314 joules per mole per Kelvin. And the value of R in calories, that is taken as 1.9. In calories, calories Kelvin per Kelvin per mole. Per Kelvin per mole. Okay? Or the value of R, that can be taken as 2 calories per Kelvin per mole. Okay? So this is how you manipulate the value of R, and depending upon what are the units of pressure and volume given to you, we take the value of R. For your competitions, generally the value of R would be given to you in the question. Okay? So I mostly we use two values, one is 0.0821 and the other one, that is going to be 8.314. Okay, then let's go on to another very important topic over here, which is known as barometric distribution. So when we talking of barometric distribution, this is one you can say topic which is not given in your NCERTs. Barometric distribution, this is not given in NCERT. Now in case of ordinary gases, what do we say? We say that pressure in the container is unaffected by gravitational field. Okay, so if you're talking of any gases which are ordinary gases, like if you're talking of hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, these are gases with low molecular masses. They are not affected by the gravitational field. But if we have gases with higher molecular masses, then which are the polymeric gases we have, jaise chlorofluorocarbons ho gaye, they are polymeric gases, right? For such gases, the pressure that is going to vary with height. That means ki the gases which have high molar masses, they are going to be affected by the gravitational force, right? So depending upon that, we have a few you can say expressions which are important from your competition point of view. Like, let's go on to the first expression. Let's take a value which is P0. P0, that is the pressure at the ground level. Right? This is the pressure at the ground level, and P be the pressure at height H. P be the pressure at height H. Now we have an expression which you need to remember, 2.303 log of P upon P naught, that is equal to minus mgh upon R. Over here, m that is going to be the mass of the gas, g that is going to be the acceleration due to gravity, and h is going to be the height, and R is going to be the gas constant. Now this expression is taken if there is no change in temperature. That is, temperature that remains constant. Okay? If in case it is temperature dependent, then the expression that changes to 2.303 log of P upon P naught, that is equal to minus mgh upon RT. ठीक है, उसी तरह से यू नो दैट प्रेशर और डेंसिटी दे आर द सेम. इफ वी हैव मोर प्रेशर द डेंसिटी ऑफ द गैस इज आल्सो गोइंग टू बी सेम. सो विद रिस्पेक्ट टू डेंसिटी, दिस एक्सप्रेशन वुड बी रिटन एज 2.303 लॉग ऑफ डी अपॉन बी नॉट, राइट, वेयर डी दैट इज गोइंग टू बी इक्वल टू डेंसिटी ऑफ द गैस. वी हैव माइनस mgh upon RT. ठीक है, और अगर हम लोग ओपन वेसल लें, नाउ दिस वी आर टेकिंग इट एज अ क्लोज्ड वेसल, इफ वी आर टेकिंग एन ओपन वेसल, द कॉन्सेप्ट इज नोन एज ओपन वेसल कॉन्सेप्ट. ठीक है, नाउ इन केस ऑफ एन ओपन वेसल, the pressure and volume, they are going to be always constant. Remember this, the pressure and volume are always going to be constant. Okay, in an open vessel. Now in this case, we know that, let's say consider one gas which has number of moles N1 and temperature T1, right? So PV that will be equal to N1 R T1. Let's say this is equation 1. Okay, let's compare it with another gas which has different number of moles. So PV that will become equal to N2. R is not going to change because it is a constant, T2. Okay, so let's say this is equation 2. Now you divide equation 2 by equation 1. So if you're dividing equation 2 by equation 1. Then what are we going to get over here? We will get equation 2 is N2R T2 upon N1R T1. That will become equal to 1 because TV and PV, they will get cancelled. Or we can say that N2R T2, that is equal to N1R T1. Okay? Or in other words, we have N2 T2, that is going to be equal to N1 T1. So this is an important expression aapki from your examination point of view. If they have given us the open orbital concept, in that case, please remember that pressure and volume, that is always going to be a constant, right? And we use the expression N2 T2 is equal to N1 T1. Okay. Now we have another very important concept over here, the difference between dry and moist gas. So if you're talking of difference between dry and moist gas, theoretically what is going to be difference? The dry gas has no water vapor, okay? Whereas the moist gas that has water vapor, because the moist gas has water vapor, the vapors of water, they are going to exert pressure, as a result of which there is a tension which is developed inside the vessel, and that tension is known as aqueous tension, right? Now if you need to calculate the mass of the dry gas, then how do we do that? For we say that according to gas equation, PV moist, that should be equal to PV dry. That should be equal to PV dry. Now, how do we calculate the pressure of the dry gas? This is very, very important. Pressure of the dry gas, that is equal to pressure of the moist gas minus aqueous tension. As I just told you, the aqueous tension is the vapor pressure of the moist gas or vapor pressure of water which is present in the gas. Okay? That is what aqueous tension is. Now taking into consideration this, when we have moist gas, we can, any gas which is moist will have humidity. Like we have it in the rainy season, there is a lot of water in the atmosphere, as a result of which we say that it is humid. ठीक है ना? क्योंकि वो humid होता है, then how do we calculate the relative humidity? Relative humidity, that is equal to partial pressure of water that is equal to partial pressure of water in air, ठीक है? Because the air that is going to be moist, right, upon vapor pressure of water. Okay, so this is going to give us the relative humidity, that is partial pressure of water in air upon vapor pressure of water. Vapor pressure of water is going to be a constant value. We know this, that whatever water is going, the vapors of water exert pressure, and that pressure, that is going to be constant. Why? Because the vapor pressure, that depends upon the forces of attraction between the atoms of a molecule. Okay? Then uske baad ek aur question jo aapko aata hai, that is, what do we understand by payload? Now what is payload? Payload basically is the lifting capacity of the balloon. Lifting capacity of the balloon. Now we know for meteorological purposes, hydrogen or helium, they are put in the weather balloons and they are allowed to raise in the atmosphere. Okay? So what is going to be the lifting capacity of a balloon containing a particular amount of gas? That is known as payload. Now how do we calculate payload? That is equal to, payload is equal to mass of the air filled in the balloon of the air filled in the balloon minus mass of gas filled in the balloon at the same temperature and pressure. Right? So you have to remember that the temperature and the pressure in both the cases, it has to be same, and minus mass of the balloon. So this is going to give us payload. Okay, so we've done various expressions in this class. The first one which we did was P1, V1 that is equal to P2. The second expression which we did was V1 upon T1 that is equal to V2 upon T2. Okay? The third expression we did was P1 T1 that is equal to P2 T2. Okay? And the fourth expression we did was PV that is equal to nRT. Now in the first expression, if we're drawing a graph, then that is known as what? Because the temperature is constant, the graphs, they will be known as isotherms. Okay? In the second case, pressure is constant, the graph are known as isobars. And in the third case, volume is constant, so the graph that is going to be known as isopores. Depending upon all the expressions which we have done today, we are going to do some numericals in our next class. Okay? So we've done the theory part of this first section, the first set of laws. We will do questions from this. Then we go on to the second set of laws and discuss at least 10 to 12 questions from that section. Okay?